The technology has been around for years, and it has been implemented. It's just the availability of the systems were not as commonplace. The training of the surgery specialists who would go on to that next level to do the micro and the nano total hip replacements was not as great. Now the kinks have been worked out. If you think about it, the total hip replacement that's happening in people right now was initially developed in dogs. The first total hip replacement was done in dogs, and then they took the system that they were developing for people and dogs to the people, made it for people, and now every grandpa, grandma, and even young athletes and young people are now getting total hip replacements. And then it took a while before it came back to the small animal world and to become commercially available and technically feasible.
It's more common than it used to be. It's becoming more and more of a appropriate way to have your animal heal quicker post-operatively. So I think that it's a good thing, and it's just like in people, when we get something done to our knee or our elbow or whatever body part that may be, PT is something that they have us do. It's not recommended, it's something that you will do for at least so much period of time. And I think with animals, they deserve the same quality of care that people do.